gears. I use them in many of my projects. And almost all of them I make myself. I used to collect gears from things like printers and photocopiers, but I never had exactly the size I needed. You can, of course, buy gears, but custom sizes can be very expensive. So really the best option is to make them myself. The simplest way to make gears is to use a cutter shaped to remove the material between two teeth. Take a cut, rotate the blank by one tooth, take another cut, and so on. This is quite monotonous, and if you make a small mistake, the whole gear is ruined. With this method, you also need a different cutter, not only for different sized gear teeth, but also for different numbers of teeth of the same size, since the shape of the tooth changes with the diameter of the gear. These cutters are normally sold in a set of 8. Each one covering a different range of teeth. A better way to cut gear teeth is to use a gear hob. This has teeth arranged in a spiral. As it spins, the gear blank also turns and all the teeth are cut at once. Note that the hob has straight teeth like a rack. Yet, as the gear teeth are generated by many successive cuts, any number of teeth can be cut perfectly with only one hob. Hobs are available in many different types and sizes. Here are the biggest and smallest I own. It's also possible to make them with a lathe and milling machine. Of course, the rotation of the gear blank needs to be synchronized somehow to the rotation of the hob. Many YouTube years ago, I posted this shaky video of a hobbing attachment I built for my benchtop milling machine. Since then, I've upgraded to a bigger machine, and I wanted to build a better hobbing attachment to go with it.
Thank you.
Okay, this video is now well over 20 minutes long, and I still have a lot to cover. So I'm going to split it into two parts. In the second half, I'll cover the rest of the construction and assembly, synchronizing the attachment with the milling spindle, and get to actually cutting some gears.